two Protestant churches on this main street is going green. Also on the main street is an entrance to its new eco-village. 5 years ago when I visited here, well-insulated timber-framed houses were going up, just as the Irish economy was crashing down.
Perhaps that this so-called petty tiger has dried up a lot of funds there for people to build. So there's constant stream of interest, and there are a few builds in the pipeline, but the building rate has slowed down quite a lot. But it's ongoing.
The 68-acre eco-village has 130 sites. 86 have now been sold, with 50 households living there. 5 years ago, the average site price was €80,000. Now, it's half that. Guitarist Peter Manley, originally from Downpatrick, is one of the residents. He used to work for an investment bank in London before moving to France and then to Clonjordan, along with his Russian wife Tatiana and their two daughters.
Here, the car is a visitor. It doesn't dominate the landscape. And the children have the sort of childhood which I had, the things you own and enjoy the development and the facilities we have. But we have quite a lot of meetings to go to and attend because we're managing the estate ourselves. So things that we would normally outsource to a utility company or to the council are done by the community themselves. So there's quite a lot of community involvement. At times that can be a bit much.
There is a lot of international interest in the village. While I was there, a bus of Taiwanese tourists with an interest in planning arrived unannounced to see for themselves. Roughly a third of the 68-acre site is residential property, a third community woods, and a third for growing food and farming. 5 years on, children now play where there was once just open space. But the residents know that mainly because of the property crash, their vision of the eco-village has yet to be fully realised, despite the undoubted progress they have so far made. Shane Harrison, BBC Newsline,